Alright, how's it going, party people? This is the last video I'm doing about the frozen orb sorcerer, sorceress. It's an endgame build. It does not focus on lightning spear. The uber uniques you quote unquote need to have aren't as bad as the rogue build I'm going to show you later. The only reason the frozen orb build works right now is because of the ring of stardust guys up here. Oh, sorry, I almost forgot. So currently I'm switching it between my my rogue and the sorceress. It's pretty much makes or breaks the build. Obviously this helps, but you know what I mean, right? I found this one recently. This was a good find right here. I could use a better one of these. I might switch this one over to my rogue. It's not that I'm never gonna play this character again. It's just I feel like, besides min-maxing, how much of it is there really to work on? This did not go higher in terms of pit levels as the necromancer from last season, with the buffs to the minions, which I think it kept. Just here's a good leveling build now, but yeah, so I'll show you the damage and what we do as a frozen orb sorcerer. The picture is a little messed up for me. Do you guys see this? I don't know. I'll look at the recording later. Let's try I'm just gonna show you the damage and like the average situation that I go through. So I haven't tried any higher, but we're gonna try 71 right now in the pit. I'll show you what I can do. Yes, that's fair as well. You know, I was at 108 at one point, but not anymore. I haven't tried at least. Okay, 71. Plenty of rune shards. Alright, here we go. Remember, this is with the Ring of Starless Skies and the Harlequin Crest as well. Other than that, there's really no other uber uniques or mythic uniques that I need, in my opinion. So, as you can see, everything is pretty much getting frozen. And you see the conjurings, of course. This is all possible because of the Winterglass amulet. Currently, every sorcerer build revolves around frozen orb, it seems like, just to proc the conjurations. Pretty easy stuff in my opinion. It took a decent amount of time to build, obviously, and obviously luck was a factor. I didn't even put on my ice armor yet, cause like nothing's touching me. I will go up or not, just in case. Alright, as you can see, my barrier is pretty active right now. I wouldn't say just one button all the time, but it can be if you want to play like that. Oh, telestomping is a lot of fun. That's when you teleport on top of an enemy and cause damage with your teleport. You can actually get the damage pretty high if you do that. And it pulls the enemies in, more importantly, so you just frozen orb them to death. Like, the velocity of the frozen orb is like just right. Yeah, maybe I should get this Fist of Fate off this character. I'm not like I said, I'm not done with her. It's just I wanted to do something else than put it that way. And yes, I plan on getting another Starless Skies ring. Hopefully I'll get Tyrion's Might first, and then we'll worry about the Starless Sky's ring. Okay. I guess it. Is this ingot 1-star? No, it's not good. Alright, so we got some, what is it, neath iron from that? I think it's like 30 we got, right? 30? I like pit level 71. I would do higher if I practice more, but like I said, this character is complete. They're not done, but they're complete. And that's all I really need right now. Just like a backup character, you know what I mean? But yeah. Did I die recently? Okay. If you want to take a look at the gear, I should link this build that I used. It was a pretty good guide. So this is my main offensive weapon. A lot of damage. This is my focus, a lot of support damage and stuff like that. Chance for frozen orb to cast twice, that's pretty important. These, I put these on because it just made sense to use them when you look at the 114.4 chill slow potency thing. Obviously as well as the movement speed as well. I could get a better one of these, not a big deal. This is probably the best I'm ever going to get. This does have a GA on it, I forgot to mention that. I just got real lucky with that. I think my farming partner found this. Well, I do more farming than them, but hey, whatever. Pronouns. Right here, the Ryman. It's like, I don't know, like, you're mainly going for the legendary aspect on this one, so I don't know what to tell you. GA on this one for the conjuration cooldowns, which is pretty important. But again, this does come with frozen orb cast twice, so you got about 3 items with frozen orb cast twice. Yeah, but a lot of, I would say a decent number of legendaries and a normal number of mythic uniques. They don't make or break the build. Like with without the Stardust guys, you have to manage your mana a little bit better. But once you got it, it's like you just go on autopilot, and very rarely will you run out of mana unless you're like spamming something like on that boss, for example. But yeah, if you look at my life, if you look at my hit points, they're fairly high. For survivability purposes, when Ice Armor and Flame Shield are both down, otherwise that attack power is not representative of the damage I do. Because if you take a look at the cold damage I'm adding to a lot of these things, cold damage, it makes a difference. In my opinion, it makes a difference. Where is that? Where's the other cold damage at? Was it here? I don't know. It was somewhere. I was lucky to get the boost of the GA onto armor because I didn't have anything else to hit the armor cap. But now, you know, we're well within there. I think my resistances are good. Yeah, my resistances are fine. I don't know how else to improve this build and switch to Lightning Spear, but like, I'm not gonna do that. This is a personal preference. When I saw it, it didn't look as fun as I thought it would be. So like this right here is simple and fun for me. So like when I just want to zombie out. But yeah, hope you guys like following this sorceress, whatever. Because I don't know what to showcase else about them. Nothing out of the ordinary. Let me put it that way. Frozen Orb was buffed. The Winter Glass was created. Some other things were buffed, like Pendant 10 Greaves that you see I'm using, even though I don't have to. So am I losing some offense from that? Maybe. But I'm not, like I said, I'm not worried about it. Yeah. I will remember this character, and she got me through some tough times. Alright, thanks for watching, guys. If anyone has any questions about this endgame Frozen Orb build, let me know. It might not be the best build in terms of pushing things, but for regular speed farming, Hell Tides, some levels of the pit, obviously, it's more than enough. But am I going to get a second Starless Skies Ring? I'm going to try to after I get Tyrio as my Ammo Rogue. So, yeah. Hope you guys enjoy that. Thanks for watching. Take care of yourselves and each other.